Welcome back. You're still watching Markets at Noon on ET Now. Well, it is the thick of the earnings season. We have another management lined up to chat with. We have Vipul, Mathur, the MD and CEO of Welspun, joining us right here on the show to talk about how the quarter gone by transpired for Welspun Corp. Mr. Mathur, thank you so much for talking to us. The profits this time around have seen a very sharp increase. What would you attribute this to?
I think it has been a superb performance in this particular quarter. You know, over all the three geographies, which is US, Saudi and India, they have been firing all cylinders. And if you see, you know, we have recorded a historical production of 443,000 tons. It's ever high in the history of Welspun. That's what we have done in this particular quarter. And that is clearly getting translated into our profits. If you look at it, our EBITDA, you know, we have recorded an EBITDA of 331 crore rupees, which is almost 37% higher on Y-on-Y basis. So is the case in PBT. It is an 81% growth on PBT and almost 108% growth on our PAT. I think so it's all about performance. That's what we attribute it to.
Margins have expanded. Do you see margin growth sustaining or this margin number sustaining?
Looks that way, because if you see, we still have an order book of almost 1.36 million tons, you know, pegged at almost 1.64 billion, for which the margins are already locked in. And the way things are moving, I think so this margin growth looks sustainable to us for at least, this order book will take us through for, in some geographies, it will take us through to the next four quarters. In some geographies, it will take us for next six quarters. So I think so this margin growth looks sustainable to us.
When we just talk about the margins, what were the trigger because of which the margin went up?
Two reasons. Number one, we have got some benefits on the steel side of it, number one. Number two, operational performance, cost reductions in our operation. I think so these two, three factors put together has significantly improved our margins.
Right. Can you talk about the US business as well? There's been a sharp uptick there. What is fueling growth for that particular segment?
US, we have been seeing in for the last eight quarters that US has been very buoyant. You know, the fundamentals of US are still very strong. They still are a net exporter of oil and gas, and you know, they want to expand their portfolio. And in order to do that, you know, they are investing heavily into pipeline network, and especially the Permian Basin. And that is which has a very close proximity to our operations in US. And we being the largest player and one of the most qualitative player in the US market from a leadership position, we are getting benefited out of that. So I think so the demand in US as we speak even today looks extremely, extremely robust to us. You know, we are still looking at, you know, we are still seeing a lot of projects coming up on the table, and we are actively participating into them. And I think so we will be in a position to cherry pick some of them in the times to come so as to take our order book in US for much longer duration.
What are the headwinds that you see in the real estate, and how is that impacting any of your business model?
The only headwind what we see could be the currency fluctuations and all that stuff. That is something which slightly disturbs our business model, but not to a large extent, because you know, we are completely hedged on that side. But barring that, if we continue to focus sharply on our performance, I think so what we have been able to do over a quarter on quarter basis, if you see our last 6 to 8 quarter performance, it has only been ever growing. If we continue to maintain our focus, I don't think so that, you know, we are actually looking at any major risk at this point of time.
The water crisis has been taking center stage. Even the PM has extensively spoken about it at various platforms. What kind of an opportunity or an additional opportunity do you see in this segment?
Huge, huge. You know, the new scheme announced by the Prime Minister for this Nal Se Jal, with the contours of which are getting finalized as we speak, I think so that is going to be a sort of a game changer. It's not going to be a game changer only for us, but just about everyone in the industry. And we are banking a lot on that. Number one. Number two, if you also look at it, the Nal Se Jal is all about water, portable water distribution to the household. But, you know, the demand in the irrigation segment is also equally strong, and all the states are heavily invested into that, heavily committed into that. And that growth in the demand is also happening in the states. So these two factors put together, I think so the water sector in India is looking very, very buoyant to us. And in which we have a major say, and we have a sort of a pan-India presence. We are present in West, we are present in South, and we are also present in the Central India, which is in Bhopal, which was our new investment. So I think so with a pan-India presence, I think so we are poised to capitalize upon this demand as well.
Right, sir. Thank you so much for taking our time for us. Always good.
Thank you very much. Greatly.
Always good to get perspective. Welspun Corp, one of the companies declaring a great growth as far as profits is concerned. The management over there talking about the US business and how that has helped the numbers. Taking a break. Coming back.